Hey everybody, welcome to your channel CAVA Infoventry. This is Brijesh here. My dear friends, agriculture is the backbone of the Indian economy. As you all know that India is an agriculture-based country where about 58% of the population is dependent on agriculture. Three bills on agriculture reforms were introduced in the parliament recently to replace the ordinance issued during the lockdown. These are the Farmers Produce, Trade and Commerce, Promotion and Facilitation Bills 2020, the Farmers Empowerment and Protection, Agreement of Price Assurance and Farm Services Bill 2020, the Essential Commodities Amendment Bill 2020. Nowadays, you might be watching on your TV heated discussions on Farmers' Bill, which were passed by Lok Sabha on 17 September and by Rajya Sabha on 20th September this year, and also widespread protest by farmers in various states, including Punjab. Keep watching this video till end to take the full benefit on this issue. Initially, at the time of independence in India, farmers used to sell their agriculture products to consumers directly. At that point of time, majority of the farmers were burdened with the debt taken from the various money lenders. Those money lenders then used to buy farmers' agriculture produce at very low price. Due to their various needs, the farmers used to take loan from money lenders who used to charge very high rate of interest from them, and ultimately the farmers were not able to repay loans along with interest, and therefore the farmers were forced to sell their agriculture produce to those money lenders at a very low price. And accordingly, next time when the farmers have to sow the new crop, then they have to again take loan from those money lenders. This was a vicious circle for farmers. Hence, farmers were not able to come out of this vicious circle of loan from money lenders, and accordingly, they were exploited by money lenders. To solve the issue of the farmers' exploitation by money lenders, government brought about the APMC Act, that is, Agriculture Price Marketing Committee Act. According to this act, the farmer cannot directly sell its agriculture produce to anyone, and anyone cannot purchase directly from the farmers. All the activities of the sale and purchase of agriculture produce shall be through APMC Mandi. If any trader has to sell or purchase the agricultural produce from that APMC Mandis, then the trader has to obtain a license from APMC. Likewise, the farmer of a particular area has to sell his agriculture produce in that particular mandi only. The system of selling the agriculture products in a specific mandi is mandatory under the APMC Act. Therefore, if any trader has to purchase any agriculture produce from APMC, then he has to obtain a license from the APMC authority. The main drawback of the APMC system is that once the license is granted by the APMC to a trader, then only he can buy the product under APMC. Licenses are provided by APMC, which are controlled by the state government. Persons who are very influential or close to the power in a particular state get these licenses to deal into the agriculture produce. With the result, what happens that the consumer gets the agriculture produce at a very high price as compared to the price which is received by the farmer from a trader for the sale of his agriculture produce at APMC. Originally, the objective to bring about the APMC Act was that the exploitation of the farmers may be minimized. The other object of the APMC Act was that farmers should not go into the clutches of middlemen, and they should come out from the vicious circle of the money lending business as well as money lenders. Over the years, the APMC Act lost its relevance because the commission agent, RTAs, and traders found out various ways to circumvent the APMC Act. Now, let us see how agricultural products are sold in APMC mandis. For this purpose, there is an auctioning system at APMC. The auction system may be divided into two parts. One is MSP, that is at minimum support price, and another system is through price discovery system. The MSP is decided by the Government of India for all states. MSP is decided by central government for 22 agriculture crops only and not for all the agriculture crops. MSP means that the auction of the agriculture produce cannot be done below MSP. MSP is the starting level and auction can be at or more than MSP price but not at the lower than MSP price. Other than those 22 crops for which the MSP is declared by central government, all other crops and agriculture products are sold or auctioned in the market through price discovery mechanism. Meaning thereby, how much is the demand and supply of a specified agriculture product in the market, the price is determined based upon that parameter, and this is called the price discovery method. Hence, the agriculture producers are sold through auction method. There is a complete supply chain for the agriculture produce from farmers to ultimate consumers. It passes through various middlemen who are known as RTAs, and they charge their commission when it passes through their hands. And hence, the price of the agriculture produce ultimately in the hands of the consumer reaches at a very high as compared to what price is received by farmer for that product. The Government of India thought that this middleman or RTAs in the supply chain of agriculture products should be removed so that its benefit can be reaped by the ultimate consumers and the price of the agriculture product can be brought down. The system of selling agriculture products is like that. The farmer will go first with his agriculture produce to the APMC or the Mandi Samiti. There, he has to contact a commission agent or RTA. These commission agents will contact the traders to whom this product will be sold. There will be a negotiation on the price for agriculture product, except those 22 items for which the MSP has been declared by central government, and there will be a negotiation based upon the demand and supply of that product in the market. For your information, the system of negotiation between the commission agent and traders is not transparent. Also, it is not digital and therefore prone to various shortcomings and bottlenecks. Once there is a negotiation between the trader and the RTA, then that transaction is communicated to the farmer by RTA that at what price his agriculture produce has been sold. The RTA charges their commission for the sale of these products from farmers. Once the trader purchases these products from the farmer, then it will be sold by him to wholesaler, then after it goes to the retailer from wholesaler, then to various vendors from whom you purchase these agricultural products. Once this product reaches in your hand as a consumer from the farmer, then the price of the product would have been doubled or in some cases even tripled. For example, we take the case of tomato. Tomato, which you are getting for rupees 60 per kg from your sabji wala, for that farmer get only rupees 5, 10 or 20 rupees per kg from trader. I shall be discussing with you the various shortcomings and bottlenecks of the APMC mandi system, which is the main reason of exploitation of the farmers by artisans and middlemen in the trading of agriculture produce. In my next video, the link of which is given above, click on the above link to watch that video. Keep watching this channel for more interesting videos shortly. Stay safe and healthy. Bye-bye.